I'm Candace, and I'm here with Be You, Be Your Own You. We are a self-esteem lifestyle brand to empower girls of all ages to love and be themselves. That is our mission, and that is why we're here. So welcome to our Inspirational Interview Series, designed to inspire, motivate, and change lives. We're interviewing anyone and everyone who has a message or story to share. You have a voice, and together we can inspire and change lives. So welcome and be inspired. With that said, I'm with the lovely Dayana. Am I saying it correct?
Dayana. Yes.
I'm not gonna give her an introduction because I just can't. She is a book of amazing stuff. And I just want to get right into the interview and let her share her story and get to know her, because there's something I can say. I'm in awe. I'm so grateful to be sitting next to you. She is so beautiful and lovely, and I want you guys to get to know her. So let's get started. So, yeah. Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Well, bless.
Well, bless. I love that.
Yeah.
So before we get into the questions, mm-hmm. I want you to give a little background of who you are and what you do.
Okay. Well, right now, I am preparing to move to South Africa as a missionary. And before that, before coming to be prepared spiritually to be sent out, I used to live in Hollywood for about 3 years. Wow. And my career was beginning to take off, and I even ended up having my own TV show called Dayana Grace Show.
Wow, that's crazy. How old are you?
24.
24, and you're about to go move to South Africa for how long?
1 year.
1 year. Okay, so I'm gonna pull up an email that she sent me prior to this.
That was a large email.
Yes.
So much information.
So much.
So much goodies.
So much goodies, because Dayana's story really is inspiring. When I read it, I was honestly in tears.
Aww.
And it was like, I can't complain about anything because of what she's been through, but also how she has overcome it. So I want you to share kind of your childhood.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I want to get right to it.
I guess we could, like, to make it easier on the viewers, we can just read from. So what I did is, like, I did an Instagram and Facebook post with a photo of me and just, like, my testimony, and it's 2 minutes, gets to the point. So if you feel like you have a really long story and sometimes you're like, it's just too long, but I do want to share it all, you can just go by the ages, and it helps out so much to just get to the point. So
that's great advice. I need
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
that's I'm good. The same way. I actually just created a video to share a story, and it was 30 minutes long.
No,
so I have to go
like
redo it.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. It's just because it's like in 2 minutes, you can give like a timeline of everything. And
yeah.
It's like, it makes sense. So I made a post on Instagram, and it's a photo of me kicking. Maybe you can put a photo there. Yeah. So it says kicking Satan in the face. And then I wrote, I was supposed to be aborted, and I grew up feeling unloved and rejected. At the age of 7, I was raped by the babysitter's son and got extremely sick due to it. At 12, I was forced to stop living with my mom in order to have a better life. And at 16, I was addicted to men, alcohol, and pornography. At 18, I got engaged, but I was physically abused to the point I almost died. I was cheated on by that same person several times. And a few months later, I went to Sacramento to party, and I partied a little too hard, so I ended up getting raped that day. At 18, because of everything that had happened to me, just like all the trauma mentally, like I didn't know it after the rape, like I didn't know if I had caught something, and it was like very scary because it was like a stranger, or I didn't know if I was pregnant. So it just like mentally, like I was already beat up, like I just lost my engagement, I lost you know, like my body was once again violated, so I just felt like ruined in every way. But at 19, I gave my life and dreams a shot, because it's like I could either kill myself or truly give life a shot, my dreams a shot. So I moved to Hollywood. I met a man who treated me like a princess and financially provided for all my needs. And I even ended up with my own TV show in the Spanish network called Dayana Grace, which Dayana Grace used to be my Hollywood name. And yeah, so But the thing is, like, at that age, I still felt empty and, like, without a purpose. Even though I had love, a TV show, I had everything, I still feel like something was missing. And then at 21, I fully gave up all my pain and also my dream of being in Hollywood to allow God to finally be my everything. So I let go of everything and went all in for God. I moved to San Diego without nothing or knowing anyone, and I trusted that God would fully provide for me, and until now, He more than has provided for me. At 23, I have been all in for now I'm 24, so it's been 2 years and 8 months living for God. I'm no longer the same. I don't have any addictions at all. My mind and heart has been purified, and just like I know my purpose. And now that I'm 24, it's like now I'm getting prepared to move to South Africa as a missionary because I went through ministry school, and just so much has happened. But one thing that has truly been impacting my life recently, and I feel like it's gonna impact the rest of my life, is like I was just, like I mentioned to you before, in a horrible accident.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, so we can probably show a photo of that here.
Yeah.
But I was in a horrible accident 2 months ago. I almost lost my life, but obviously God's not done with me yet. My car flew up in the air because I was hit from behind, and my car rolled 3 times on the freeway. But by the grace of God, I'm still here, and it's changed my perspective about like life and just everything else. It's like, it's crazy how like, I mean, I guess it makes sense, like, but how one accident can change how you think, what you do. Like, I don't look at things the same way anymore, like material things, nothing. Like, even my family, like, I'm so protective over them. And like a few nights ago, I got to the point where I'm like, it's nothing is mine. Everything we have is borrowed from God, even our own lives. So if He wants, He can just take it away. So I think I'm in this place where I'm finally like surrendered.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, wow.
That was a lot, huh?
That was a lot.
But it got to the point, and I really like getting to the point.
No, yes. But wow, you guys.
Yeah.
And it was Dayana Grace. You're full of grace.
Yeah, I mean, it's crazy that Hollywood would rename me Grace, which is crazy. And then after I was renamed and the show happened, I decided to let it all go.
Well, I think bring it back, the name, because you are full of grace.
Aww.
Your smile, her smile is so radiant. Give this video a like really quick for her being vulnerable.
Aww.
Sharing that with all of us, all the viewers, and for this beautiful smile. Like, wow, you just light up the room.
Thanks.
How did you get saved? Or like,
Well, I've always like known about God. I just didn't want anything to do with Him, because it's like, growing up, I was a big rebel. Like, I did whatever I want to do, and I'm the type of person that when I'm gonna do something, I'm gonna do it right or just not do it at all. So that's why I did, like, if I party, I'm gonna party hard. If I go hard, I go hard.
Yeah.
But I always thought, like, if I were to live for God, I'm gonna do it the right way, or I'm just not gonna waste my time, because I don't believe in being lukewarm. Like, I believe either you're in or you're not, and I like doing things the right way. So for me, it was like, I did not want to have to submit to God, especially because like my trust was broken, and I was like, I just couldn't understand why there would be a God and so many things would happen to me. But I finally got to the point where like, I was 21, I had everything. I mean, a TV show, money, boyfriend, everything. Like, like someone who actually wanted to marry me. Like, I finally had everything I was searching for, that security, because I didn't grow up with security. And I, like, the lights were in front of me. Like, everybody, like, people were getting to know who I was.
Yeah.
But it's like, I was, like, I understand when the Bible talks about dead bones, because, like, even though I had everything, I was dead inside. I was, like, every day, it was like I was a walking zombie. And, well, I just got to the point where I realized it didn't make sense. And I had a business meeting with somebody that wanted a commercial in my TV show. And we were just talking business, and then out of nowhere, like, this girl starts talking about faith, about how, like, every time she's had faith in God, He would show up powerfully. And she was showing me powerful examples that explained faith.
Yeah.
And I didn't really understand what it meant, having faith in God and allowing Him to show up. And so she just shared, and something in me moved, but I didn't want to share how much, like, her testimony had impacted me, because I think I was still trying to process. And I went home that day after my business meeting with her, and I just got on my knees and I said, like, God, like, I'm such a coward. Like, I like money, I like sex, I like everything more than you, but I also know that you've been calling me for a long time, and I was like, I'm tired of running from you. So I was like, if you are truly real, God, and you want me to live for you, because I realized that living for God meant that I was gonna have to let go of my old life, yeah. because it's like I was gonna do it the right way.
Yeah.
So I prayed that prayer, and I asked God that to come rock my world. So in 2 weeks, he came and rocked my world. In only 2 weeks, he rocked my world. Different people were messaging me on Facebook about God, Bible verses that were really speaking to me, and people talking to me about God, like certain things that only God knew what I was going through. So in 2 weeks, I let go of my life, like the TV show, my boyfriend, everything. And if I broke up with my boyfriend, I was going to have to let go of the TV show, because he was a producer who financially gave me all the money for everything. So I decided to let everything go. I moved to San Diego 2 years and 9 months without nothing. I think I only had like for sure less than $2,000, and I didn't really have any work experience.
Wow.
So I moved here like with nothing, and God has just been so faithful, like so faithful. Like in these 2 years and 9 months, I have been able to go through ministry school, which ministry school was $6,000. I just came back from South Africa. And like it's I like that, like what I've noticed in living for God is like every time you take a big step of faith for God, only doors that God can open will open up. So God by himself like has opened doors that I can't even explain.
I mean, that's faith right there, and you know, that's believing.
Yeah.
And that you're a walking miracle. You are the depiction of faith. Which is crazy. So you just What led you to come to San Diego?
I remember in high school, like I would always, with one of the people I used to be really close friends with, like I would always, like my dream was to like graduate high school and move with my best friends and like live together and work and build their life, and one day we would eventually get married and go our own ways. But that was my dream. So I remember in high school, like I would always say like, oh, we should live in San Diego. And like in high school, like San Diego was always in my heart, even though I had never been to San Diego. I just knew it was surf city, and I love the beach. So I couldn't, when I decided that I was gonna truly live for God, I knew that I couldn't stay in LA because I didn't want to go back to my old ways. And there's nothing wrong with Hollywood or TV stuff. It's just like, to me, Hollywood and men and money was such a big idol that I had to kill my idols, which I have. I've been killing my idols. So I think in God's timing, I will probably go back to Hollywood, but this time it'll be in a different person, purpose to like share his love and do whatever I do for him.
I think when you're in a situation that you were, there's temptations. If you're not strong enough,
that's so true.
If you're not strong enough, you have to step back from those temptations. Even though it's like, I will go back one day, but when I'm strong, when I'm a rock, nothing can knock me down. And I just watched this video with Michael Todd.
Yes, love him.
And he talks about when you're filled with the Holy Spirit. He got a jar and he put ping pong balls in it. And he was like, when you fill water and it's like the Holy Spirit, you know, you're filling yourself with love, Jesus. And eventually the balls fall out, all the ping pong balls fall out, and then he's basically saying, you're so strong, so look how happens when I put the ball back in there. He puts the ball, he's like, it's just on the surface. So that goes with anything, you know, if you're just filled with love with Jesus, and someone comes, these temptations come knocking at you,
you're like, there, what,
you have so many walls. I think that's why that's an amazing story. So we're gonna kind of jump around, but what advice would you give anyone who might feel the same way? I have everything, you know, I have the money, the man, you know, my dream career, like, well, what you think my dream career, you know. What advice would you give to those girls or even males out there who's like, I have everything in front of me, but I don't feel fulfilled, I don't feel like I'm living?
Sometimes like if you truly wanna like leave, like if it's not, if what you have right now isn't fulfilling you, then you need to do something different. Like for me was, I had to leave everything behind where I had no way of going back, where it's like sometimes you have to put God in a spot where it's like, God, if you don't show up, like I'm gonna be in trouble. So for me personally, I like being put in positions where it's like, God, if you don't show up, I have nothing. So putting, and it's like, if you already have the money or like you can't lose it at all, that's fine. I'm not telling you to lose your money. You don't have to do that. I'm just saying, like, whatever is an idol for you, you need to kill those idols. It's just so that doesn't have control over you, because mm-hmm. the only one we should be idolizing is God. We live in a society where it's easy to idolize our phones, people, yeah. Family. So you need to be in a point where it's like, no, God, it's only you or nothing at all. So just putting yourself in that position where it's like, no, God, it's just you or nothing at all. Like, right now I could probably, again, like even right now, which is funny, like I even had another interview recently where it's like I've been having interviews and it's like, you know, you see the lights and little things here and there, but it's like I gotta come back to that place where it's like, no, it's not about me. And like recently things have been going really well for me and mm-hmm. I've been getting super spoiled. Mm-hmm. So I felt for a second like I was getting fluffed up again, like there was like a little bit of like sassiness coming back. So I was like, I went into my prayer time yesterday and I was repenting. But before going into prayer and repenting, like, I will not go back into that place where it's about me, because it's not. So I even made sure, and I'm going to make sure I do it no matter, as like, if, you know, if I keep getting opportunities, like, I'm going to do it. Because I was like, yesterday I went and cleaned the toilet to remind myself, like, nothing is about me. And I said, God, like, the more doors you open for me, the more people's bathrooms I'm gonna go clean, because I'm never gonna get fluffed up. And if I ever get interviewed in like a super crazy place or whatever happens, or big doors, like I will make sure I clean their bathrooms, because like I never want to be in a position where I think that I made it happen or that it's about me, because it's not. So I know it's a funny way to put it, but like, it's just like cleaning a toilet brings me back to,
yeah,
like no, you're just the human, and yeah. you are where you are because of God.
Yeah, I love that, because I think it also talks about like remaining humble.
Yeah, like
I'm really big on that, is remaining humble through it all, because
yeah,
the most successful people out there, they genuinely start at the bottom. I don't, even if they were born into money or into wealth, they still had to start somewhere small.
Yeah,
and I think that's why you have to, and that, there's like that saying where it's like you need to treat the janitor nice, because yeah. even though you weren't a janitor, you were in that position.
Yeah,
so I think it's, yeah, I love that.
Yeah, no, so just like
I always tell my dad, because things are going really well, but she is probably one of the most humble like persons out there that I know, but I'm like, you gotta remain humble, dad, through it all, remain humble yeah. and giving, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, like it's not like, I think, yeah, I just believe, I'm a big believer that like God's the one that opens yeah. door, and it's not for us but to shine his light.
Yeah, that's why I think you're here, like your purpose, you're one of his yes. purpose, that's why you're here, this is why I'm here. I think my purpose is here to interview women like mm-hmm. you, and all because of him, you know. Yeah. He's using my voice, his platform, he's using your yeah. voice, your story. Yeah. So do you, I know this would be a personal question, but do you regret your past? Do you regret anything that's happened to you?
No, I really don't. I just, how I feel about that is like, I wouldn't be who I am without that. Like the things that happened to me that I didn't make happen, and the things that I did make happen, like I wouldn't trade it for the world, just because like I have such a like merciful heart, and mm-hmm. I always say like, I know what it's like to be the pig, and I know what it's like to be like holy as God is holy, to want to be better and sanctify myself every day. And like, I wouldn't take it back, because it like right now that I'm going to South Africa, like I wouldn't be able to understand like rapists, murderers yeah, without that, because I know what it's like to be messed up in the head, and I now know what it's like to be transformed by the grace of God.
Yeah, I've been learning a lot lately about compassion. Compassion's been a very strong word that I've been hearing. I don't know where I first heard it, but since I heard it that
yeah.
moment, I've been like hearing it over and over. And I was just talking to my boyfriend, like no matter what someone's going through, they have compassion. Yeah. And if they're maybe not a nice person, or they're struggling, or maybe they're doing things that you don't agree with, you yeah. have to have compassion, because there's something behind that person. And I think that's true. Like yeah. when you go to South Africa, you'll be able to have compassion and kind of understand it, but also help and be like, there is light at the end of the tunnel, you know. True. I'm here to show you that I've been here and now I'm here.
Yes.
Can you talk about compassion? How do you feel about compassion?
How I see it is that like all of us have been in a point in our life where we're just like messed up, and we want to treat people bad or do bad things, But then there comes to that point of like remembering God's grace upon us. Like, yeah. Jesus died in that cross, yes. Not because we were perfect, but because we were like, we were the worst of the worst. And his blood, like he sacrificed himself, literally being spit on, beat up on, like nails up, like literally, I can't even imagine. When I get a little cut, it's like the end of the world. To imagine, like, I just think like, who am I to think that I'm better than anybody? Yeah. And then another thing that I watched recently that just made me fall on my knees and cry for compassion and mercy for others was The Shack.
Oh yeah, I always talk about that movie. Yeah.
Like, I love the part where I think, yeah, the Holy Spirit in the movie comes to the dad and he's like, if your daughter or son murdered someone and they had to go on the cross, would you let them, would they deserve to go on the cross, or would you rather take their place? And the dad said, I would rather take their place, and he would love his kids the same. So that's God for you right there. Like, Jesus loved us so much that even though we were so messed up and we should have paid the own price, Jesus went on that cross to pay the price for us.
Yeah,
I know. I love the movie.
Yeah, I was just like, once again, I was talking about that with my boyfriend. I'm like,
you're always, you know, yeah, we're so similar.
Yeah, I was just saying, because I love that movie too. So what you mentioned earlier about when you were in that business meeting, she talked about faith and like it made you see differently. That's how I am. I'm a very visual person. You can tell me things and I might not grasp it. So with The Shack, it really, it's especially from the Trinity, I didn't really understand that. I never really did, even though I knew it, I didn't understand it. So with that movie, it really showed it to me in a different light and I was able to grasp it.
Yeah.
So, and just like forgiveness, and I'm a very big on forgiveness.
Yeah.
One, because I want to be free. Forgiveness sets you free. But also just like the movie, it talks about like he had to basically forgive his murderer.
Yeah.
And I was just talking to my boyfriend, I'm like, you know, we're talking about someone that we know. And it's like, well, do you deserve forgiveness? And he's like, yeah. I'm like, well, that person deserves forgiveness too. You know, he's like, we're not better. And if maybe if you're watching this and you are struggling with maybe who God is, I recommend The Shack. Because for someone who was a believer and who has strong faith, that movie just, like I said, opened different doors. And it made me view things differently.
Yeah.
And it's just amazing. Like, I don't want you guys to think like, oh, like, yeah, you know, I just watched it. Like, it's an amazing movie for everyone, and you will just, it'll open your eyes.
Yeah.
I just wanted to share that part because that's a great
such
movie.
Such a powerful movie.
Yes. So, well, you kind of answered my question, because I asked you if you regret your past, because some terrible, terrible things happened to you at a young age. And I know there's some girls who maybe are watching this who are in the Me Too movement, have been sexually abused or a victim, and they don't speak out, or they haven't spoken out, maybe they have. But what is advice that you can give to them that's maybe been through rape, being sexually touched, violated? What's advice you can give to them?
Yeah. Well, definitely, like, not being afraid to share your testimony. Like, I know it can be hard, but it's important to share first with people that you know you can trust. For me, like, I just tend to be very open. I'm like a book. I can share easily. But what was healing for me in the beginning was sharing, like even making videos about it. But I realized that, like, through sharing my testimony and my hurts, I have seen so many women, including men, be healed. Like, I remember I spoke at at an event, Voices of the Heart, and like I just saw people like be moved, even like gay men like coming up, like saying like, wow, like I just like sometimes. So one of the verses that I absolutely love in Genesis, it says that what the enemy intended to harm, God will use it for his glory and for the saving of many lives. So like, I realized like that what all the bad things that have happened to me, it's not because of God. He didn't make it happen, because just as God is real, so is Satan. But like the enemy, like Satan, tried to destroy me, but that same destroyment is now giving life and hope to all these people that are broken. So I would say, like, don't be afraid to share and be open, because it's like Satan tries to keep you in silence. And I truly believe that, like, that's why a lot of people have sicknesses and illnesses in their bodies.
Wow.
Because it's like you're holding on to something that hurts you so much, And so your body generates sickness. Yeah. So you need to share and forgive and move on. I know it's not, I'm not just saying move on and you can do it like that. Like, I get you can, but definitely share, be open, because it's like the more you share, the more you heal, the more you forgive, the more you move on.
Mm-hmm. The more you'll be free. You said that perfectly.
Yeah.
That is amazing. I really love how I said that. Because I know I'm going back and forth, but I was at this event in Lewis House. I don't know if you know who that is. I didn't know who he was, but he's a big motivational speaker. I guess he was sexually abused. Mm-hmm. And at the event, there was a panel, and this girl went up. I don't remember the exact question, but had everyone's jaw drop. Like, she just asked that. Or like, wow. And she asked Lewis, and then another girl on the panel was also sexually abused at a young age. She basically asked, like, you know, she said that she admitted that she was sexually abused at a young age. She was like, how did you forgive your abuser? You know, how did you do that? Because I personally don't want to forgive my abuser.
Yeah.
And both of their answers, they both had amazing answers. They both were like, I wanted to be free. You know, so they were holding this power. So you're talking about power?
Yeah.
They were holding this power.
Yeah. So good.
And I think also when you share, like, when you are vulnerable like this and being open, and if you are like her, you have this story that you've been bottling up. When you do, I think, share your story, it's gonna save someone
that's
else.
That's so true.
Because that there's someone else
to be open.
Yeah, because I feel like once I have people who are able to watch this video, there might be a viewer going, wow.
Yeah.
Like, she went through, oh my gosh, I did that, like, wow, you know.
Yeah.
And look at how beautiful and radiant she is. Like,
yeah.
Well, have I missed anything?
Nope, I think we've got it all covered. I mean, I would say that when you allow God to be your healer and do the work, you're just not gonna recognize yourself. I don't recognize myself anymore either. Like, I'm not the same person. My identity used to come from like glamour and men and everything, and it's like now, like, it's, I still have some of that. Like, my identity doesn't come from that, but I'm still glamorous, as you can tell. And but I am happily single. I don't find my identity in being in a relationship. Like, my identity comes from God, knowing who I am in Him. So it's like, if you just allow God to do the work in you and you truly give Him time and trust Him, you're never going to be the same. There will be days when you're following God and you don't see Him move, or you don't feel like He's near, but you just hold on to Him on by, like, never let go and follow Him no matter what, and you'll see a huge transformation.
Yes. That goes, I know we're about to wrap it up, but that goes into that question about identity with men. You said that you really found, like, you were, you know, you craved men, you wanted to seek men to give you that identity. That is great advice, because I think there's a lot of us females out there who it's like, we want acknowledgement from our boyfriends, or we want to have that man in our lives who's going to, you know, make us feel this type of way. So really quick, I guess, I think when you love yourself and love yourself within God,
it just And you know what, like, I was sharing with her earlier, like, sometimes, like, we're trying to find something that God wants to give us in men. Like, I was sharing with her, so, like, I wear a purity ring, so I always have it on. People think I'm married, and I do not care. But, so I always, like, when you're in a relationship, sometimes you're like, oh, I just want my boyfriend to buy me diamonds or buy me this and that, because you're, like, finding your identity and, like, what they give you. But I found mine in God, and, like, I, like, in this time that I have been here, like, God has provided for me to even buy, like, a true, like, real engagement wedding band with diamonds and white gold all over it. And even for my birthday, like, it's just a friend, nothing else, a friend that truly respects me. And he used to be, I used to run a group in church, so just a really nice person. But I even got from a friend a diamond necklace. Like, what? Like, who gives you diamonds for your birthday? Like, and I'm just sharing this story because it's like, in the past I would have died over a man to do that for me, but now I'm not dying over anyone. And like, God's just like, I feel like God will use people to send you reminders. And I have female friends that have done things for me that I would have died for a man to do for me, like bringing me roses and doing things. So it's like, now that my identity is from God, like, He uses different people to say, like, here, daughter. Like, it's so amazing.
Yeah, because when you're filled with the love of, you know, Jesus, when, like I said, these temptations no longer are really temptations. Maybe some days, yes, but you will stay grounded. and you don't let these maybe toxic men or maybe who say, oh, I'm buy you this, but I'm gonna
you have to do this.
Yeah. So you will receive, you know?
Yeah, without nothing, like they don't want nothing in return from you. Yeah. They really don't.
Yeah, so it's that's amazing. Pretty nice. Yeah. I think when I always say love yourself first. And I will say if you have God in your life, it's so much easier. Yeah. It is so much easier because that process is easy. I'm actually I'm in the journey of loving myself again. I used to be the most confident girl 3 years ago and I gained some weight. And I'm kind of in this battling of insecurity, but I will say with him on my side and you know, knowing that he is there, that's why I didn't want to make YouTube videos. I know I'm not talking about me, but just it's an example, you know.
Yeah.
I didn't want to do YouTube videos because I was like, oh my gosh, what people are gonna think, you know, but who cares? I don't care anymore.
No, it doesn't matter.
I'm
for his glory. Yeah, so yeah, definitely for you ladies, gentlemen, if you have a dream, if there's something you want to do, do not care what people think about you because there is freedom in just being you. I feel like that's something God keeps bringing up a lot lately. Like, just be you. Like, who cares? Like, yesterday I even made a post for some friends for their birthday, like a song singing happy birthday. And like, I'm super insecure about singing, but I really wanted to sing for this. I just sang that. I did not care. But like, just be you. Like, who cares if it looks funny? Like, it could be blessing someone else just being you. So whatever dream you have, don't care about what others say. Don't think it's not good enough. You only get better by doing it more.
Yes. And the more you start really being yourself, you start finding this family who loves you for you. And it's like,
yeah, I mean, if I would have never shared my story, I wouldn't be here.
Yep. And if she wouldn't be here, she wouldn't be sharing it with you guys.
Yeah.
So thank you.
Just share. Yeah. And share this video.
Yep. Like, comment, share. So anything else? So we can wrap it up?
Nope. I would just say hold on to God and just remember that God does have a plan for you. So that's why I love Jeremiah 29:11. That's us. For I know the plans I have for you to prosper you and not to harm you, to give you hope and a future. And that's what God has for you. So keep holding on.
Yes, amen. Cool. My last question is, how can I help you or how can the BU community help you? What can we do for you, Dayana?
Well, if you guys want to help, like I said, I'm headed to South Africa. I will give her the link.
Yes.
I'm going to be there for 1 year as a missionary. So all donations help, and they're not just for me, but they're also to make a difference in the neighborhoods out there and bless other people as well.
Yes. So I'm going to share that link below, guys. If you love her and love this video, please, if it's anything, if you can donate anything, it'll go a long way for her because like she said, she's going to South Africa to change lives there for victims and for anyone who needs her. She's going there to serve. So anything helps you guys, it goes a long way. And let me tell you, I just donated to a charity the other day and it was a little amount, it was only $20 and I felt good inside and I know it's going to be good. So if you really feel good about this, please go help, but it would go a long way. And I would love for them to go follow you.
Oh my gosh, yeah, find me on Facebook, we'll be friends. Yes. And I really do not feel like, oh my gosh, I want to message her, but I can't. No, message me. I love talking to people. My Facebook, you can find me under Dayana Madrigal. Maybe you'll put the link here
too. Yeah, put the link below.
And then Instagram is Dayana Madrigal 777.
Yes.
Yeah,
so she just opened the door, guys. If you want to message her, message her. She's an open book, like she says.
Yeah.
And I know I already have a few friends who I know is going to love this video. Aww. Who's probably going to want to reach out to you.
Yeah. I love friends.
So, yeah. So do I. I love people.
Me too. And coffee and cakes.
So we're about to go get some coffee.
We are.
So with that said, you guys, thank you so much, Dayana, for being here. We already love you so much. You're a part of the BU fam. Guys, always be your own you and love yourself first.
Love.
Bye. Okay.